Welcome to another tutorial by Supreme Tuber. In this video, we will be discussing how to implement a high pass filter using generalized impedance converter. Alright, so if the question is asked in the exam, it can be asked in two forms. Either it will be asked as implement a second order high pass filter using general GIC, or it can be asked identify the type of filter and realize it using GIC. If the question is asked in this format, this kind of filter configuration will be given. You first have to calculate the transfer function and prove it that it is a high pass filter, and then you have to implement it using a GIC. And if the question is asked in first configuration, you have to first draw this circuit and then prove that it is a high pass filter, and then you have to implement it using a generalized impedance converter. Alright, so to learn all these type of configuration, I have provided a link in the description of Sedra Smith. You can go refer chapter 12, page 1108. Okay. So, I have already discussed the basics of generalized impedance converter. If you haven't watched the video, go check out the link which pops up in the top right hand corner right now. And if you want to watch the video on low pass filter using GIC, go check out the link which pops up right now. And if you want to watch band pass filter using GIC, you can go check out the link which pops up right now. Alright, so let's get down to the basics. So this is this will be our standard high pass filter configuration, which it has one capacitor, one inductor and one resistor. Okay, and first I have proved that it is a high pass filter by simply calculating the transfer function. This is our input and this is our output. You can simply apply Kirchhoff laws to calculate the transfer functions. I will not get into Kirchhoff laws. I'll simply show you how I have done it. V0 is equal to the impedance across these two terminals divided by total impedance. Okay, so the impedance between these two terminals will be the parallel combination of R and L. Okay, so this will be this R into SL upon R plus SL, and the total impedance will be the series combination of this capacitor combined with R and L. Okay, so this will be this, and if you simplify this circuit, you get V0 by VI, which is S square upon RCL upon S square RCL plus SL plus R. As the numerator contains a S square term, therefore this will be a high pass filter. Okay, so no matter which type of question is asked, the first step will be to prove that it is a high pass filter using standard configuration. Now what we will try to do is, we will try to replace the inductor with a combination of op amps which we will call generalized impedance converter. Okay, so the question, some students may ask the question, why we replace the inductor and not the capacitor or the resistor. You have to remember one thing. You have to remember just one thing. It is difficult to build high value and high quality on chip inductors. Okay, this is a linear integrated circuit. Okay, this all these high pass filters will be present on a small chip, and building inductors on a chip is very difficult. Therefore, what we try to do is, we always try to replace inductors with op amp type of components. Okay, so we will try to replace inductor. As I have already discussed in the basic video of generalized impedance converter, this was the basic generalized impedance converter. The equivalent impedance of the generalized impedance converter, input impedance, is given by this formula. Okay, this formula, this was our basic GIC configuration, and this was the formula. And if you want to implement an inductor using this formula, you have to simply put these three as resistors of any value, and out of these two impedances, one as capacitor and the other as resistor. Okay, so this was our simple GIC. Now we try to replace L with an equivalent GIC. The input impedance of the GIC can be given by ZI is equal to Z1, Z3, Z5 on Z2, Z4. Substituting Z1 is equal to R1, Z2 is equal to R2, Z3 is equal to R3, Z4 is equal to 1 by SC4, which means Z2 can be replaced, is being replaced by the capacitor, and Z5 is equal to resistor. Okay, so this ZI becomes S times R1, R3, R5, C4 by R2. Okay, so if we put these values of impedances in a standard GIC configuration, we will get an equivalent inductor which will have a L equivalent value of R1, R3, R5, C4 by R2. As you can see, ZI is equal to SLQ, L equivalent, where the value of L equivalent is this. Okay, so now what we will do is, we will try to replace simply this L with a GIC in which the impedance values are these. Okay, So this is our GIC, this is our input impedance, this is our capacitor, same as here, this is our resistor, same as here. Now what we will try to do is, we will try to put a GIC between these two points, okay. One point is this and the other point is ground, okay. So one point is this and the other point is ground, okay. Simply a GIC is replaced instead of an inductor with the values, these values, okay. Very simple. Okay, so Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4, Z5, these respective values are put here and we have obtained a high pass filter using GIC. Okay, so this was a very easy video. Do subscribe to the channel if you liked my concept. Thank you for watching.